newspaper on Monday that this would be the bleakest week for our nation fighting this coronavirus. And I thought we really need to pray for everyone that's been affected. We're praying for you to be healthy and your families to be healthy. We want to pray for this virus to be driven from our land and from the world. In 1 Kings chapter 20, we read that King Ahab was fighting a battle with Aram. And Ahab faced fire at Mount Carmel, victory over vast armies, drought and rain, and each was for Ahab's benefit. The Bible says that he would know that God alone was Lord over the nations. I think it's good for us to pray, Lord, use this crisis to bring us all closer to Christ. Help those that don't know you to come to Christ and see that you're the help we need. I also thought it was interesting that they said this would be the bleakest week. I think it's fitting that Easter falls this week on the calendar, because you see, during Holy Week, by the time they reached Friday, it seemed like all hope was gone. But Sunday changed everything. Easter reminds us in Christ we have a living hope. Let's pray that we can reach out to others and share the living hope we have. Now, you can join us. I've got a list here of the opportunities, and you can share these with friends, neighbors. Tonight, Wednesday night, we'll be on at 6 p.m., Pastor Chad with our youth ministry on Instagram and Facebook Live. Then Don Pittman with our adult Bible study at 7 p.m. on Facebook Live. Tomorrow morning, Thursday morning, 11 a.m., women's Bible study with my wife, Laurie Kent. Then Good Friday, we'll be on Facebook Live at 8 p.m. The Children's Easter Story Saturday at 10 a.m. and Easter Sunday at 10:30 a.m. And this information will be on our website and our Facebook page as well. Share it with others. We have a living hope. God bless you.